गुड इवनिंग। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द पैरामीटर पासिंग इन फंक्शंस इन सी प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज। इन पैरामीटर पासिंग वी मस्ट नो व्हाट डू मीन बाय एक्चुअल पैरामीटर्स टू द फंक्शन एंड व्हाट डू मीन बाय फॉर्मल पैरामीटर्स टू द फंक्शन। एक्चुअल पैरामीटर्स आर द वेरिएबल्स डिक्लेयर्ड इन द मेन प्रोग्राम, ओके, एंड दे आर पास टू द called function. So the variable declared inside the main program are called actual parameters, whereas the variables declared inside the function definition are called as formal parameters, or it is also called as dummy parameters. There are two different types or ways by which we can pass the parameter to the function, that is by call by value, or it is also known as pass by value. Second is call by reference, or it is also known as pass by reference. We'll see the first method now, that is call by value method. In call by value method, we have to remember three important points. The first point is, in this method, one copy of actual parameter is given to the formal parameters. Okay, it means that only a copy of the actual variable is given to the formal variables or dummy variables. So the called function works on the copy but not on the actual parameters. Hence, any changes made by the called function are not seen by calling function. That is, the changes are not get reflected into the actual parameters. To understand this concept of call by value, we'll take an example of a hard disk. Say there are two different drives in your hard disk, C and D drive. Suppose there is a file abc.txt in C drive. Suppose if you copy the same file into D drive and you make changes into the D drive file, suppose, whether that changes gets reflected into the C drive file? Never. Okay, the changes are not get reflected into C drive file automatically. So the same thing happens into the call by value method. The changes are not reflected into the actual parameters. The changes are reflected only into the formal parameters or dummy parameters. To understand this very well, we'll see the program to swap two numbers using call by value method. Write a C program to swap two numbers using call by value method. So here we declare all the header files, stdio.h, then conio.h, then void main, the start of the program. Here we declare the function, that is swap, which takes two integer numbers, and there is no return type to the function, semicolon. It is just declared here and defined later. So there are two variables a and b, integer a equal to 10 and b equal to 20. Clear screen, we'll clear the screen. This line will print the values of variable a and b before performing the swapping. So here a will gets printed as 10 and b as 20. After this line, we actually call the swap function. Swap in bracket a comma b, it is nothing but we call this function using call by value method, and values of a gets copied into x, whereas values of variable b gets copied into variable y in the function definition of swap function. So in this case, x becomes 10, y becomes 20, and this is the logic to swap two numbers in C program. We take a temporary variable, temp equal to x, x equal to y and y equal to temp, will swap the values of x and y, and the swap function will print the message that in swap function x equal to percentage d and y equal to percentage d x comma y. This line will going to print that x equal to 20 and y equal to 10, because here the values of x and y gets swapped. But when the function gets complete, the compiler comes to the main program again and execute the next line after the swap function. After calling swap function, will print a value and will print b value, and here you will get the result as a equal to 10 and b equal to 20, because the values of a and b are not affected by the swapping of the values of x and y. So in the call by value method, the values are affected only into the called function, but it is not affected into the calling function. Okay. So the output of this program is, before calling the swap function a equal to 10 and b equal to 20, in swap function the value of x is 20 and y is 10. After calling the swap function, a value is 10 and b value is 20. If you see, before calling and after calling, there is no change into a and b variable. The change is happened only in the function variable, that is x and y. In this program, only x and y value gets changed and not the values of a and b. So, actual parameters remains as it is in the call by value method. Now, we'll see the other method of passing the parameters to the function, that is call by reference method. Here also, in call by reference method, you have to remember 3 points. In call by reference method, we pass the address of actual parameters. The address of actual parameters is given to the formal parameters or dummy parameters. So, the called function directly works on the actual parameters. Hence, any changes made by the called function are directly seen by the calling function. The changes are directly reflected into the actual parameters. In case of call by reference method, we use the concept of pointer to pass the reference to the formal parameters. Okay, what do you mean by pointer? Pointer is a special variable which stores the address of another variable. It is declared by the symbol asterisk in front of the variable name. With pointers, we normally use two operators. One is called address of, represented by ampersand symbol. Another is value at the address of, represented by asterisk. For example, if you see in this line, integer a equal to 10, comma, pointer p. In the next line, we are assigning the address of a to p. It means that p is the pointer which is pointing to address of a. And the next line, we are printing the values of a and the pointer p. You will get the result as 10, 10. So, p is the pointer which points to the variable a. So, whenever you print pointer p, you will always get 10. But whenever you print ampersand p, it means you want to print the address of the variable p or variable a, it is going to print the address of a. Now, we will see one program on call by reference method to understand it very clearly. Write a program to swap two numbers using call by reference method. So, we will start with the header files, hash include stdio.h, then hash include conio.h, void main, opening the program by opening curly bracket. Then we declare the swap function in the main program using pointer variables. Void swap integer pointer variable 1, comma pointer variable 2. There are two pointer variables we have passed here. We declare variable a and b with the values 10 and 20, semicolon. This line will clear the screen. Here it will print the message that before calling the swap function a value and b value. Here this is calling the swap function and check how the swap function gets called. Here the parameters are passed as the addresses of variable a and address of variable b. So address of a gets copied into a pointer variable x, whereas address of b gets copied into a pointer variable y. So if you read it properly, it is nothing but value, pointer is nothing but this asterisk means value at the address of a. Pointer y is nothing but the value at the address of pointer variable variable b. Okay. So addresses of variable a and b are directly passed to x and y. And this function is responsible for swapping the two pointer variables. If the two pointer variables are swapped, it means that the value inside that variables are also get swapped. The value inside this variable are nothing but the address of variable A and address of variable B. So the values inside that particular address also get swapped. It means that this function not only swap the values of X and Y, but also swap the values of A and B variable. So in the after swapping, in the swap function, we'll print the values of X and Y like this. X equal to percentage D, Y equal to percentage D, double quote close, comma, pointer X comma pointer Y. So this will print the value of X and this will print the value of Y. After printing this, the compiler goes back to the main program. After that calling line, the next line is, after calling function swap, A value equal to percentage D, B value equal to percentage D, and it is stored in A and B. In this case, you will find the output on the screen as, before calling swap function, A value is 10, B value is 20. In swap function, X is 20, Y is 10. After calling swap function, A is 20 and B is 10. If we check the output of the previous program using call by value, swapping the two numbers using call by value and swapping the two numbers using call by reference method, there is a slight change in the third line. That is the output line after calling the swap function. Here if you notice, here the values of actual parameters are also gets swapped. So in call by reference method, it not only changes the values of the formal parameters, but also it changes the values of the actual parameters. So actual parameters are also gets affected in call by reference method. Okay, so this ends call by value and call by reference method. If you have any doubts, you can ask me now. Any doubts? Okay. Thank you for watching the video.